I should mention that there's one place where I try to calculate what can be accomplished by loops of neurons that are arranged in a circular pathways, so that if you put a certain pattern in, it will sort of echo around. And I showed that mathematically that under some conditions, the information that you originally put into such a loop will be gradually destroyed and the pulses will become equally spaced. And that's sort of interesting because I had trouble proving this. And one day I ran into another graduate student named John Nash, and I said, how would you deal with this problem? And he looked at my description of it and he said, well, why don't you expand that into a Fourier series? And I said, oh, well, let me think about that. And I couldn't figure out what he meant, but after a couple of hours, I figured out what that would mean, and then I did it, and I proved this theorem. And so John Nash actually must have solved a lot of problems for other students around Princeton while he was working on his big theory of optimal strategies for games. But in particular, this was a problem that I just casually asked him one day, and he promptly told me how to solve it, although he was too busy to actually solve it himself.